Hello and welcome to Fit, Fabulous, and Over 50. I am your host, Renee Miller. The goal of this show is to teach you how to become fit in the privacy and comfort of your own home. You will learn both functional and practical exercises designed to tone your muscles, increase stability and balance, promote core strength, and get your heart rate up. Each week, we will present different exercises designed to isolate certain muscles of your body. We will also show you what you can do to stay fit in any room in your house. Now, if you've never exercised before, you should get a physician's release. And if not, if you're ready to go, let's get started. If you've had any time at all in your life to play a sport, you've probably injured a shoulder. Most people who have had any time to spend swinging clubs or rackets have at one time or another injured their shoulders. Today we're going to show you what you can do to increase the strength of your shoulders and to rid yourself of those problematic pains in the shoulders. Let's go to the muscle chart. All right. Today we're going to be talking about many different muscles, starting with the most internal muscle group, the rotators. Although they're not seen on the chart because they're intrinsic or internal, they're deep inside the muscle under the clavicle and behind around the scapula. These muscles are designed to rotate the shoulders. In addition, we're going to be working on the muscles in the exterior, the front, middle, and rear deltoids, and a little bit into the trapezius and teres major and minor. All of these are designed to work the muscle groups. Now, let's get a little warmed up, because before you do anything with your shoulder muscles, we need to warm up. So let's get the music going, stand up, and remember, you can't get fit watching an exercise show. Let's stand with your feet hip distance apart, abdominals lifted up, shoulders are down. We're going to take a deep breath in. Lift up, palms are facing your head, and down again, breathing in and down. Good. Now, hands on the thighs, knees right over the toes, hips are back. Just round your back a little bit, press the hips out, round the back again, and roll all the way up. Good. All right, let's pick that beat up. On your right, right, left, here we go. Nice and easy. We want to get your heart rate to go up a little bit. Good. Keep it going. We're going to step to your right, to your left. Here we go. Just slice in. Yeah, that's it. Four more times, you're going to leave your toe to the outside, and you're going to do a little reach. Stretch the body up. Keep the arms down, warming up the lower body. We want to get that heart rate up just a little bit. Four more. Listen. Three more. We're going to add a bicep curl to the front. Down low. Here we go. Pull it up. Good. Now all we're trying to do is increase the core temperature of your body a little bit. Working a little bit bigger now. We're going to swing those arms about halfway front. Just about chest high now. Listen. Elbows bend, take the arms to the side. Good. Down up. Deepen your step down and up now. You want to get that heart rate up. Start feeling yourself breathing a little bit heavier. Good job. You're doing great. Four more. Listen now. Palms facing the ceiling. You're going to sweep up. Reach high. Pull up off of the rib cage, not from the shoulder. Get those ribs off those hips. Think about growing taller. Four more. Three. You're going to sweep it across your chest. That's good. Cut across. Palms are facing the ceiling. Four more. Everything has a reason. Now slice at a diagonal. Down. Good. Four more times. Listen, friends. March it out on your right foot. and just do some shoulder rolls. Good. Four more shoulder rolls together. Listen, you're gonna isolate. You're gonna go right shoulder, left shoulder, right shoulder. Four more times, that's excellent. We're gonna reverse both shoulders to the front, front. Two more. Again, four, three, two, one, and just isolate forward, 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 and that's all. Take a big, deep breath in. Oh yeah, and exhale. Do it again. And down. Let's take a big stretch for the back. Hands on the thighs. Round your low back. Feel the stretch all the way down. Press the hips out. One more time. Roll it up. Good job. Okay. That's great. Now we're ready to work the shoulders from here. And just relax. All right, now. Let's go get your soup cans. We want to talk about the rotator cuffs today. And we're going to start by using light handheld weights, or you might want to use little handheld weights, or soup cans are great. We're going to stand in a lunge, one foot in front of the other, hip distance apart, holding onto your soup can or your little weight, hand on the thigh, weight is just a little bit forward, press the back heel down. Now, we're going to work on warming up the rotator cuff muscles as we spiral your can from the smallest spiral out to the biggest one you can do. Make it very, very succinct. Work. Think of a pencil drawing a spiral, making it bigger and bigger and bigger. Go out as far as you can and then reverse it. Slowly bringing the circle back in. Good. You want to make sure that you cover all the territory between the smallest spiral to the largest. That's right. Let's repeat it with the other side. Hands on the thigh, abdominals lifted up for support. Start spiraling out very, very small. This is going to warm up deeply into the rotator muscles so that when you begin to move your muscles in larger movements, you don't have to worry about injuring them. Reverse the circle. Keep it going. Good. And you want to slowly bring it all the way back in. All the way back in. Good. All right, now, you can do that a few times each side. This is going to help you warm up, and this time you're going to start out and slowly work your way back in. Let the shoulder relax. Don't stiffen at the neck. Abdominals and chest are supporting you. All the way in, fluid movements to the smallest spiral right in the center. Good. Let's try the other side one more time. From the largest circle, you're going to slowly bring it in. And this one's harder for me. Left hand is harder. Some people will find you have one side harder than the other. And you want to bring it in and slowly spiral it deeper in until you finally reach it all the way into the center. Good. All right, now, if you've done that a few times, you're going to find that you've warmed your shoulder muscles up, and they should feel easier to move forwards and backwards. So now we're ready to work the rotators in an internal and external fashion. If you have an exercise tube just like this, you can attach it, or a TheraBand. You can attach it to a door handle or a railing or a chair. You want to hold the exercise tube in your hand, elbow into the side, 90 degree elbow right at your side, and you're going to rotate the hand across your belly and back. All right, so we're going to go out, in and out. Good. When you do this, you want to think about keeping your chest tight and your abdominals lifted up. This is to work your internal rotator muscles in your rotator cuff. And we really, really want to strengthen them because they're such a small muscle group. If you don't strengthen them before you do the larger muscle groups, you're going to end up with sore rotators. Let's do four more. And three. Keep your abdominals tight. We're going to do one more. Now, we're going to switch sides. I'm going to turn around. Still keep that elbow down to your side. Tighten the abdominals. And the rotation goes to your outside now. And you're going to go away from your body. Away. Good. And you want to really push it to the outside without moving the elbow. You want to keep that elbow locked down to your side. Now, I want you to think about tightening up your gluteus maximus and your lower abdominal region. This is going to help support you when you do all your movements. And if you're playing a heavy sport like racquetball, where you're thrusting with your shoulders, you should be working those abdominal muscles all of the time to get stronger and stronger. Let's switch sides. We'll start with the external rotation on this side. Here we go. Good. Good. Now you're going to find that you may have one shoulder that works easier than the other. One shoulder is stronger than the other. I have that. My left shoulder's been injured a little bit. It's definitely a little weaker. So these are excellent exercises. You can do these at home. You want to try to do them in two or three sets of 12. You can do them just about every day. Keep the movement going. You're doing a great job. Good. That's it. Let's just do four more on this side, and then we'll switch. That's four, and three, and two. And we're going to turn around and do the internal rotation. And again, you want to make sure that you're really lifting up in your abdominals, and you're going to cross across you here. Pull it away, pull it towards you, rather. Tighten your abs, tighten your glutes. Think about using the rotator muscles. Don't bend the wrists. Notice the wrists stay straight and strong. The elbow stays locked into the side. You want to make sure the rotation comes from the shoulder and not from the elbow. Keep it going. Let's finish it. Four more. And three. And two. We're going to do just one more here. All right. Excellent job. Picking these up, they're easy to find. You can find them at any sporting store of your choice. All right. Now, we've done our rotational exercises, which are very key. We're going to now start doing something that most people do often all day long. We're going to use just small soup cans, your small cans, and you're welcome to use weights. But I want to make a suggestion. If you're not used to doing shoulder exercises, start extremely light, because if you don't, you can end up hurting something and you won't know about it until it hurts tomorrow. Light weights down by your side. I want you to rotate your palms towards you. When your palms are rotated towards you, you're going to have the optimal amount of movement in the shoulder. The flexion movement is just straight out in front of you and back down. Now, do not take your cans or your weights any higher than your shoulders, all right? The higher you go, the more you're going to put pressure on the shoulder muscle or on the shoulder joint itself, and you don't need to do that. We don't need to do that to be effective. All right, so we're just going to do about 12 muscles or 12 repetitions here with these muscles. Keep it going. Excellent. Keep it going. And you want to make sure you're breathing now, friends. Be sure not to hold your breath, okay? Breathing through the contraction. We're just going to do a few more here. Good. And just two more. And one more. And take a little rest. If you have found that it's difficult for you to straighten your arm in that movement, then bend the elbow and do them closer into you, all right? You may find that if you've had shoulder injuries in the past, it's actually easier to keep the elbows bent. We are not trying to make our shoulders turn into big, rock-hard, hulky shoulders. We just want strength and endurance. We want no pain in our shoulders. Isn't that right? All right. So those are your flexion exercises that we can do. Let's do two or three sets of 12 of those, and we're going to put them down. Now, before we go to the floor, I want to talk about using your abdominals and your back to stabilize you, all right? So we're going to use a stability ball. You can use a cushion on your floor. You're going to take your cans and tucking your abdominals as hard as you can on your ball. We're going to do a little extension. Now, if you're not sure about this, drop your knees to the floor, pull your abdominals in, and you're going to start by sweeping your arms out to the side and think about rotating the shoulder blades until they come together. Good. You're doing a great job. Pull in those abdominals. Don't let your butt stick out. Lift up your belly. Good. Now, for a variation of this, a little bit harder workout, you're going to tighten the tummy and really pull in the abdominals. This is excellent for your core strength now. Oh, yes. Now we're really working. Now we're getting stronger. To do a deeper extension, you're going to bring the shoulders or the elbows back along the body line. Stretching out, pull back. Really tighten up in the gluteus maximus. Yes. While I keep going and while you keep going, let's see what you can do anywhere else around your house.
Household chores. Everyone has them. To prevent injuring yourself doing simple household chores, I have a great exercise for you. They're called push-ups. Push-ups are one of the best exercises you can do, and you can start with them right in your own kitchen at your sink. Let's watch. Here's what you're going to do. You're going to stand with your feet about hip distance apart. You want to have your knees lifted up, but not locked. Tuck your glutes, give them a good squeeze, and pull up on your abdomen. Arms about shoulder width apart. Step back maybe a foot or two from your sink, and your whole body will slowly lean into the sink and then push away. Now, this is a great beginning push-up, especially if you've never done them before. You want to make sure you keep your legs lifted up, your feet flat on the floor, and your abdomen lifted so you don't arch your back. Once you get the hang of it, you can begin to work deeper in the muscles by actively resisting pushing away. So instead of just a flimsy movement, it's a movement that works in opposition to itself. Yes, that's right. You want to keep those shoulders down. Now, I have to tell you, push-ups are a great exercise. If these prove to be too easy, you can go to the floor and start with knee push-ups. You'll do primarily the same move, only you're on your knees and your hands. And if those are too easy, try those tough toe push-ups that we all watch other people do. Push-ups are like going to a sale and getting 50% off the lowest markdown price, because they work almost every single muscle of your upper body and your abdomen, so they're an excellent use of your time.
Raking can be an enjoyable weekend activity. Well, depending upon the number of leaves. Truthfully, though, long after the leaves are bagged and put by the curb, you may still have muscle stiffness and soreness. It's important to warm up before you do leaf raking. Let me give you some pointers. First of all, I suggest that before you do any raking at all, you do 2 to 4 minutes of brisk walking. If you have a long driveway, take a walk to the mailbox and back. If not, use your yard for a survey time, and while you're walking, begin by doing very large shoulder rolls. When you do these shoulder rolls, you want to relax the chest, breathe, open the chest up. Repeat going the opposite direction. Relax the back. The more circulation you can get in the shoulders and the back, the less chance of soreness you'll have later. All right, very good. Now, let's warm up the deltoids and across the back. What you're going to do is bring your arm across in front of you. Take your left arm, bring it across in front of you with your right hand. Press gently away from the shoulder line. Stretch, hold, and breathe. You're going to feel this stretch across the shoulders and into the back. Good. Let's try the other one. Crossing over, stretch, breathing. Good. Very good. All right. Now, if you've got your rake, you can use your rake as a handy tool to help you stretch. We're going to lift the rake over our heads. Keep your abdomen taut. Tighten your glutes, hands above you, and stretch up and over. This stretch is for your lats, your back, and all the way down into the hips. Breathe and reach and go the other way. Really lift. Good. Excellent. From the side, you want to make sure that you pull up out of the waistline as you do this. Good. Very good job. All right. Now, one more thing. Let's stretch your low back and your hamstrings. Make sure that when you rake, you bend your knees and keep your abdomen tight. I want to tell you a secret. You can avoid the 2 o'clock vendor run. You know, when it's 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock in the afternoon and you just find yourself at the vending machine, there's a secret. Spend more time during the morning eating or grazing. Eat little, lots of times. For instance, a handful of baby carrots, an apple, try a little can of tuna, and then replenish your fluids. By the time you get to the middle of the afternoon, you won't be so hungry and you won't be so frazzled. You won't feel so drained. Maybe you won't even need that next cup of coffee to get you through the evening if you drink more water. Walking is a great way to burn extra calories, get that heart rate up, and stay in shape. But before you take a long walk, you really need to stretch your muscles to prepare. You don't want to get injured walking. Let's do some stretches together. At the fence post or at the wall, place your hands on the fence post and step into a lunge, pressing the back heel down. When you lengthen through the back heel, be sure to keep your abdominals tight and your gluteus maximus contracted. Lunge forward. This stretch is for your calf muscle. We're going to hold that there just for a few seconds. And I'm going to show you a variation of this stretch. Bend your knee now, and you'll feel the stretch go immediately deep into the calf muscle. This one you want to hold and breathe. This works deep into the muscle to warm it up. Good. Now, the next stretch, lunging in the same position, but pulling the heel off of the ground, the hip goes under and down you go, stretching the big, big hip flexors. Those muscles work quite a bit while you're walking. Keep your glutes tight, keep your abdominals contracted. Good. Let's repeat this one on the other side. I'll show you this way. Pull the knee under the hip and drop straight down. Good. Make sure the hip stays aligned and doesn't buckle or bend. Now, quadricep stretch. Pick the heel up and pull the foot towards the glutes. Tighten your abdomen so you don't lose your hip line. Watch you don't sink or let the knee come forward. Stay pulled up. Good job. Finally, Let's get the backs of those thighs. Put your leg up on the fence post or out in front of you. Pull up and reach slowly over. Oh, what a beautiful day for a walk. Warming up all the way up the back of the legs. Good. Repeat on the other side. Stretching before you walk will make your walk much more enjoyable, and you will find that you can get a larger stride and more results. For a variation on what we just did, and also working the middle deltoid now, you can either lay on a small bench or a chair, or if you have a stability ball, it enhances your workout so much. Get your soup can or your handheld weight, elbow down to the side at a 90 degree angle, and you're going to work the elbow towards the shoulder from the shoulder joint. Now, this is really important. You don't want to change the path here. You want to keep the path nice and straight as the elbow goes up. Notice the wrist goes with the motion. It doesn't separate or deviate. You definitely don't want to bend at the wrist now. You want to really force the shoulder joint to do the work. You can do this at longer levers or shorter levers, depending upon your level of conditioning and how you feel. If you have shoulder problems, turn your palms up to do this one and rotate with the palm up. You're going to find that you get less impingement and a much, much better, less painful movement. That's great. All right, I'm going to turn mine in, and we're just going to keep on going for just another minute. You want to really work on that. Make sure you do a couple of sets of 12 on each shoulder. We'll just do four more here, and three, and two, and one. You make sure you do your shoulder. One more thing, friends, I want to show you, especially if you're doing heavy shoulder movement and heavy shoulder flexion and extension. Stability ball is a great way to get core strength, hands on the floor, come up on all fours, really tighten your abdominals now. And you're going to do an opposite arm and leg lift, face down, looking at the floor. Good. Make sure you really pull up in your abdominals. Don't forget to breathe. Don't hold your breath. Switch and go the other side. Yes, you're going to find one side is a little bit less balanced than the other. We're all asymmetrical, and we want to work to become as symmetrical as we possibly can, especially for our chosen profession. Good. All right. Let's do one more time each side. Tighten those abs. Breathing. Good. Yes, you can do it. And one more time, switching, pulling up, tighten the abs, squeeze those glutes, and make sure the head is staying in line with the rest of the body. Roll back. Take a little break. How are you feeling? I bet you're feeling great now, and so am I. One more time, and tighten your abs as you roll forward. Squeeze those glutes. Increase your workout by lengthening through the legs. Good. You're awesome. I'm so glad you joined me today. Tighten your abs. Make sure you're finding your balance right in the center of your body. Good job, everybody. Thank you so much for joining me, and I'll see you next time on Fit, Fabulous, and Over 50.